How's it going, everybody? It is Shane, aka Turk Murphy. Thanks for stopping by. Today I'm going to show you how to edit your own GIF and put it as something that you can have pop up for a follow alert, a donation alert, whatever you want. I'll start the video off by saying there probably is a quicker way of doing this, and it might be on YouTube, but this way seemed really easy for me today. It only took me about 20 minutes to figure out how to do, and my GIF and follow alert came out really well. So the first thing you want to do is find a YouTube video that you like, something you want to convert into a GIF. Something that'll be funny or unique for when someone hits the follow button. Here I chose Gollum dancing around, stoked that he has the ring. So what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to copy the URL and you want to go to clipconverter.cc. It's my favorite website to do it. It's trustworthy. It's easy. And you hit MP4 and then continue. It's going to open up some random window, close it. Now, you can do whatever quality you want. I just go with high quality, standard quality. You know, you're going to have a very small GIF on your stream, so it's not super, like, mandatory to have extreme quality. But, I mean, if you can, then by all means. File, name, Smeagol dancing, that's fine. And then you're going to hit download, and that's going to start downloading the file. All right, so you got the footage that you want. You got the song that you want. Just for an example, I got what I had previously downloaded for a video I was making. So this is what I'm working with for the example of the alert. All right, so something really easy, something simple, something fun, unique. That's what we're looking for here. Okay, so for this portion of the video, there's probably an easier way to do this, but my way really isn't too difficult either. You need an audio file to go with the GIF. So basically, I just re-exported the same video that we just got done editing, and I went to MP3 and then exported that. So we're going to be using both of these files during this process. So now you've got your finalized video, you want to go into your web browser, you want to go to easygif.com. Like I said before, if you've got your own video to GIF websites, then by all means, use those. This one just worked for me. You're going to go to video to GIF, choose file, Happy Gollum, and hit upload. Now this should take, it shouldn't take too long. It really depends on the size of the file that you're working with here. But since we are working with GIFs, it's probably not going to take too long. All right, so now that your video has been converted to a GIF, you want to make the end time the duration of the video that you're working with. And I'm not going to lie, I haven't really screwed too much around with the size, the frame rate, and the method. But the default has worked fine for me. And now you're going to hit convert to GIF. Now, if you don't want these black panels here, obviously you just crop it, adjust it to however you want, and then hit save, and it'll automatically start downloading to your computer here. Okay, so you have your GIF, and you have your audio for your GIF. Now, I only use Streamlabs, so I'm only savvy on how this works. I don't know about the other programs that people use for their Twitch streaming. But if you have Streamlabs, you're going to go to Alert Box, and then you go under your Follow Editing section. From here, you're going to upload an image, which is our GIF that we have, and you're just going to click and drag it over. All right, so once it's loaded, we're going to select the one we want and hit OK, and now we have that as a GIF. Now, we're going to go to the sound and do the same exact thing. Okay, so now we have both the files where they need to be. This is when you adjust duration. I doubt you're going to be working with a 48 second GIF. Mine is only 10 seconds, so I'm just going to put this here. And now we're going to hit save settings. All right, so on top of the GIF and sound being loaded, obviously this is your message template that will read as the person follows or donates. You can have the bouncing text, zoom in, down, and fade out. You can do anything you want with that. It'll be directly below the GIF if you have it here. Obviously, the layout determines what it's going to look like. Now you want to go up to test follow alert and Alright, that concludes the video, everybody. I appreciate you stopping by and watching it. I hope that I could help you with your Twitch streaming experience. And if you do have an easier way of doing all of this, then I would love a personal message or a comment or something. Thank you guys for your time, and don't forget to follow me on twitch.tv/TurkMurphy.
Filthy little hobbitses. No! No!